To start, thank you the Brain Foundation, its donors, sponsors, and committee members for the generous gift. This award will play a vital role in supporting the diabetes and dementia research study conducted at the Florey Institute of Neuroscience, the Melbourne Brain Centre, and the University of Melbourne. I also thank you on behalf of my research colleagues, Associate Professor Amy Broadman, Professor Louise Burrell, Dr. Sheila Patel, and Dr. Matthew Pace. Dementia and diabetes are two of the most common and disabled conditions worldwide. Type 2 diabetes is one of Australia's fastest growing chronic diseases. With respect to dementia, around 1,300 new cases are diagnosed every week in Australia. There is also increased awareness that the two conditions are linked. People with diabetes tend to have worse memory, perception, and thinking. And there is a strong association between diabetes and Alzheimer's disease, which is the most common form of dementia. In addition, research has shown that individuals with diabetes have a greater rates of brain volume loss with aging. Unfortunately, there is little evidence that treatment for diabetes may result in reduced dementia risk. As such, better biomarkers are needed for the prediction of cognitive decline in people with type 2 diabetes. Left ventricular hypertrophy, which is the enlargement and thickening of the left lower chamber of the heart, is common in people with diabetes. There is also evidence that diabetes in heart disease may accelerate the production of two proteins named beta amyloid and tau. The increased deposition of these two proteins in the brain is associated with Alzheimer's disease. So within this context, the Diabetes and Dementia Study seeks to establish whether participants with type 2 diabetes and with left ventricular hypertrophy have increased rates of brain atrophy, cognitive decline, and amyloid and tau depositions. Understanding if diabetes and left ventricular hypertrophy contribute to depositions of tau and amyloid will allow us to identify individuals with greater height of dementia risk. This is essential for implementing targeted disease-modifying therapies. The results of this study will provide unique information about the relationship between diabetes and dementia, and may answer the question whether cardiac, structural, and functional abnormalities are associated with cognitive impairment in people living with diabetes. With the advent of aggressive risk management strategies for cardiovascular disease, as well as potential amyloid immunotherapy for Alzheimer's disease, the identification of these patients will allow them to be treated early in the course of the disease, ideally before the development of cognitive dysfunction. So thank you again to the Brain Foundation for supporting this research, and thank you for your attention.